Okay, so the next question I wanted to talk to you about was your curious place in origin debates. One way I see it is that there's basically, for Christians, there's three major groups. There's young earth creationists, and these people think the universe is really young, like 6,000 years old, and they don't accept evolution. Then there's old earth creationists, which you're in the camp where you accept all modern science as far as cosmology, but you disagree with what modern science would say about evolution as taught in the state universities. And then there's evolutionary creationists, which would say that they totally accept all modern science, all cosmology, all evolutionary science and everything. So you being in the middle, you can agree with the young earth creationists that evolution is not good science, but you disagree with them on the age of the earth. And on the other side, you can agree with the evolutionary creationists about the cosmos and the age of the universe, but disagree with them about evolution. So how's the life in the middle there? What's that like for you?
Well, it's pretty lonely because nobody is happy with us, with our position. And, you know, what really motivates our view is essentially the idea that we take what science presents very seriously, and we take scripture very seriously, and we're looking at how can you come up with a model that would integrate both accounts, the biblical account and the scientific record, recognizing there may be places where there is tension, where there might be points where there is conflict, or at least apparent conflict. And so in those places, we might then challenge what might be a more commonplace or, popular interpretation of Scripture, but we also might be willing to challenge certain scientific ideas. But the idea is that any challenge that we bring to a biblical interpretation or to a scientific idea has to be, based on a rigorous critique that has hopefully legitimacy to it. And so that's essentially what we're trying to do, is really integrate a biblical account and the scientific account, trying to be true as we can to both enterprises, but yet also be willing to go against mainstream thinking in science or in certain areas of theology if that need be.
Well, let me say something. Tell me if you agree with me or not. It seems to me within Christianity that the young earth creationist viewpoint is a minority opinion, but in the public sphere, as far as what you hear, it sounds like it's a dominant position as far as the voices. Does that seem what do you think about that?
I don't know that I would agree or disagree with that statement. I think in my experience, at least among evangelicals, probably young earth creationism is the dominant view. But a lot of times people hold to that view without ever having thought through the issue. So they kind of hold that view from a default perspective. But an increasing number of evangelicals actually are moving towards at least either embracing or at least acknowledging the legitimacy of an old earth perspective. I think I actually saw recently some survey data done by Lifeway Research where they said roughly 50% of evangelical pastors are comfortable with an old earth position, but only about 25% would be comfortable with evolutionary creationism. So you have a preponderance of evangelicals being anti-evolutionists, for lack of a better term, but about 50% being young earth creationists. But then if you broaden it to include not just evangelicals, but mainline Protestants or even Catholics, then I would actually think old earth creationism is probably, or at least an old earth perspective, is probably extremely widespread. And when you include mainline Protestants and then Catholics, you probably are looking at a very high level of evolutionary creationism.
So, the Catholics, I would like to talk to a priest sometime, but I just, kind of impossible to find somebody that would talk, I think, so far. Let me know if you ever know of a priest that would like to talk to me, but...
Sure.
would you say the priests are like the evolutionary creationists?
Yeah, I would say that.
Boy, yeah. I don't know, I'm really perplexed about that. I grew up as a Catholic and then I became a born-again evangelical Christian. Catholicism is really strange. One time I met a priest, we were talking about the soul, and he was talking about how the soul emerged and everything, and I was saying, you know, that makes sense, but that seems like it's against the Catholic faith, and he goes, well, you know, I don't know, you don't really have to believe everything, I guess, or don't tell anybody or something, I don't know, you know, something along those lines or whatever. The Catholics are used to believing whatever they want to believe, I think. It's kind of strange.
Yeah.
I mean, they're still trying to work in Adam and Eve and with evolution. I don't know. I think that's a breaking point myself. So I would love to challenge. I want to get some of these BioLogos people, I guess. I've talked to them about that, too.
Well, you know, I mean, in a sense, that's why, in large measure, I hold the position that I hold, is I don't fundamentally have a problem with the idea that God could use evolution as a way to create. But then when I look at the biblical account of human origins, I just don't know how to square that with the idea of human evolution. And so in a sense, that kind of forces me into a position where I have to be skeptical to some degree about facets of the evolutionary paradigm. However, you know, when I was an agnostic in graduate school, it was really the inability to account for the origin of life that convinced me there had to be a creator. And so... Since my first year of graduate school, I've been a skeptic of the evolutionary paradigm when it comes to the origin of life. So, you know, I've never held to the idea of chemical evolution. So, I mean, there are things I think that the evolutionary framework cannot account for, at least as things currently stand. And so that also, I think, in part fuels my position as well, as I do see places where I see the evolutionary paradigm is insufficient. That's partly, again, why I hold the position that I hold. You know, I think that the age of the Earth is extremely well established from science, but I think it's very easy to square that idea with a reading of Scripture that I think upholds the integrity of Scripture. But
Who do you feel closer to, the young Earth creationists or the evolutionary creationists, do you think? Do you kind of tilt one way?
I probably feel closer to the evolutionary creationists in the sense that I think evolutionary creationists are much more actively involved in a truth-seeking enterprise because, you know, at least with people from BioLogos, I think they acknowledge kind of the biblical and theological issues that are associated with their position, and they're wrestling through those issues. And I would like to think that our work at Reasons to Believe is more characterized by that, where we're not necessarily dogmatic on a lot of our positions, though we hold to them firmly. Mm-hmm. We're still wrestling through and modifying and refining things, whereas I don't see that characterizing young Earth creationism.
Hey, let me ask you a question. Do you think that, this might be a funny way to phrase it, do you think the young Earth creationists are, if they see a science-religion conflict, they are bending towards the religion or tending towards believing the Bible literally if there's a conflict? They want to go to the Bible over science, and that the evolutionary creationists are the opposite way, where they're going to science more than the Bible if there's a conflict? Do you see that kind of bend?
I would agree with that characterization. Yeah, I would agree with that characterization, and you know.
And then you'd probably say that you're a middle ground. You're doing it just right.
Well, I mean, everybody, of course, you know, holds their position for, you know, for reasons, you know, that they think are sound reasons. But, you know, in a sense, you know, our perspective is if you see conflict between, let's say, what you think Scripture is saying and what science is saying, our approach is essentially to reevaluate our interpretations and to ask the question, do we have our interpretations correct, not only of Scripture, but of science? And so, you know, at Reasons to Believe, we have gone through, you know, closed-door exercises where we've asked the question, you know, do we have to embrace a historical Adam and Eve? And, you know, we always come out of those deliberations saying we just don't see any way around it. But we have gone back and evaluated, you know, kind of a traditional understanding of human origins and, you know, again, through that exercise come out saying, no, I think this is really the way to understand Scripture. And likewise, you know, we evaluate scientific ideas in that same way. You know, but I guess my sense would be if I reached a point where I thought that this is what Scripture says and it is in conflict with science, I probably would give deference to Scripture at the end of the day. Because I've also seen situations
where the science changes? Or
yeah, where over time science has changed and, you know, and where what something that looked like to be a serious challenge turned out over time to actually, you know, provide support, you know, for the Christian faith. So
okay. Can we go on to another topic?
Sure.